गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, दिस इज़ द थर्ड लेक्चर ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग थर्मोडायनेमिक्स। इन फर्स्ट एंड सेकंड लेक्चर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द बेसिक पार्ट, स्टिल वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग विद द बेसिक पार्ट ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स। वी हैव गॉन थ्रू कोर्स ऑब्जेक्टिव्स, कोर्स आउटकम्स, देन सिलेबस, डेफिनेशन ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स, एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स, dimensions, examples of dimensions, then dimensional homogeneity, laws of thermodynamics, then system boundary and surrounding thermodynamic system with some example, property of system, thermodynamic equilibrium, path process and cycle, reversibility and irreversibility. Let's start with quasi-static process. Quasi means almost and static means steady. This quasi-static process is almost steady process in which the state change from point 1 to point 2 is very small. State change from point 1 to point 2 is very small and it is considered as a steady state and very infinitely small change in the system. Therefore, properties at both point is considered as same. Quasi-static process. Quasi means almost. A quasi-static process is also called a reversible process. This process is also called reversible process because at every point of a state, the process is proceeded by very infinitely small distance. Therefore, at all infinitely small distance, a property is said to be a constant. Therefore, at point 1 and at point 2, properties remains constant. Therefore, this is called as a reversible process, and this during this process, temperature remains constant. This process is a succession of equilibrium state and infinite slowness. It is characteristic feature. This process is infinite slowness. It is very very slow process. To reach from one point to another point, it takes a long time. It is a very very slow process. Therefore, every succession point is considered as we can say at every succession point the property remains same as that of previous points. During the quasi-static or quasi-equilibrium process, quasi-static process also called as quasi-equilibrium. You know what is equilibrium? We have already studied the equilibrium. Equilibrium is stable. Quasi-static or equilibrium process, the system remains practically in equilibrium at all times. The state of simple compressible system is completely specified by two independent intensive properties. Two independent intensive properties may be pressure, volume, temperature, entropy, enthalpy. Okay. Now look at here. Process 1 to 2 is divided by an infinite number of points. Okay, I have divided into infinite number of points. Consider point 1 and subpart 1. From point 1 to subpart 1, it is a very, very small distance. This distance is infinitely small. Therefore, I can consider as property at point 1 and property at subpoint 1 is the same. Okay, now process further moved from subpoint 1 to subpoint 2. Again, distance between subpoint 1 and subpoint 2 is infinitely small. I can consider the property at subpoint 1 and subpoint 2 is same. Okay, and I can go further for remaining points. Therefore, I can say the property at successive point is same as that of previous points. Therefore, such processes are called as a quasi-static process, and this is a very, very slow process. Okay, now quantum. A matter is made up of atoms that are widely spaced in the gas phase. It is in very convenient to disregard the atomic nature of a substance and view it as a continuous homogeneous matter with a whole, that is quantum, continuum. Consider a gas molecule are very widely spaced. Consider a gas is enclosed in a cylinder, but we know gas molecules are widely spaced. It is not like liquid and solid. Gas molecules of solid is compact, they are bounded. The molecules of liquid is less bounded, they can cross the boundary. The molecules of air or the gas is not bounded at all, they are moving here and there, okay, they are moving continuously. The atomic gap between atoms or the molecules is wide. Even though the gap between those molecules is very large, but they are in a space and they are moving around each other. Therefore, such phenomena is called as a continuum, and the gap between two atoms is called as a continuum. Despite of the large gap between the molecule, the substance can be treated as a continuum. Listen, despite the large gap between molecules, there is a large gap between molecules, a substance can be treated as a continuum. Continuum means they are combined. Because of very large number of molecules, even in an extremely small volume, even in an extremely small volume, there are very large number of molecules, and these molecules are moving around each other. No doubt there is a gap between two molecules, and that gap is nothing but a continuum. That gap connect them. State. We have already seen the state. State is a particular condition of a system at a particular time. It is a condition of a system at a particular instance of time. It's called a state. Consider a process is starting from point 1 and point 2. When it starts from its initial point 1, it has some property like pressure, volume, temperature, enthalpy, entropy. This property characterizes the state of a system. When it moves from state 1 to state 2, its state changes and it has come to the different property, and that different property where it has come now represents the state. State of a system indicates the specific condition of the system. To know the characteristics of the system quantitatively refers to knowing the state of system. Thus, when the property of a systems are quantitatively defined, then it refers to a state. When the property of system are quantitatively defined, when property of a system is defined, like a condition of a system at a point 1, say pressure 1 bar and temperature 30 degrees Celsius or a volume 1 meter cube, this gives the property of a system. Okay, this gives the state of a system. When the system changes, when the state changes of the system, it reaches to another pressure, temperature, volume. Say it is reaches to pressure, say 2 bar, temperature 50 degrees Celsius, okay, volume may be different, then it reaches to different state. Okay, now at point 2, whatever the condition or whatever property of a system represents the state. State postulate, the number of properties required to represent the state. Minimum two properties required to represent the state of a system, just like pressure, temperature, pressure, volume, okay, temperature, entropy, temperature, enthalpy. Minimum two properties are required to characterize, to represent the state, and the minimum number of properties required to fix the state of a system is given by the state postulate. It may happen that some system may require more than two properties also, or the minimum number of properties required to represent the state is called as state postulate. The state of simple compressible system is completely specified by two independent or intensive properties. Always properties are the intensive property. Two intensive property, okay, independent or two intensive property may be extensive. Not necessary that is intensive. Volume is an extensive property. State may be represented by pressure and volume. Pressure is intensive property and volume is an extensive property. It may be represented by temperature and volume, temperature and entropy, temperature entropy, temperature enthalpy. Temperature is an intensive property, enthalpy, total enthalpy, total entropy. These are the extensive property, but we if we consider specific entropy, specific enthalpy, then these are the intensive property. Microscopic and macroscopic point of view. Macroscopic, let us consider microscopic first. Suppose I am doing research on a system, but I am doing research superficially on the particular system. Suppose there is one object, I am measuring its dimension, I am measuring its force acting on it, I am measuring the physical structure, shape, I am doing superficially. Then this superficial study is called as a microscopic approach or microscopic point of view. Now microscopic, if I am studying that system in depth, in a molecular or atomic level, suppose I am studying the intermolecular force, bonding between that force, heat is supplied and what is change in the molecular level, if I am studying, then such study are called as microscopic point of view. Macroscopic point of view is called as a classical approach, classical thermodynamics, and microscopic is called as a statical thermodynamics. We study mostly microscopic point of view. Thermodynamic studies are undertaken by the following two different approaches. First is a macroscopic approach. Macro means big or total, and micro means very small. These approaches are discussed in comparative way below. Here we have differentiated macroscopic with microscopic approach. In macroscopic approach, a certain quantity of matter is considered without taking into account of event occurring at the molecular level. Listen, in this approach, a certain quantity of matter is considered without taking into account the event occurring at a molecular level. We do not consider at a molecular level. We consider at a superficial level. Forces, temperature, say volume, shape, okay. In other words, this approach to thermodynamics is concerned with a gross or overall behavior. This is known as classical thermodynamics. Then microscopic approach. The approach considered that the system is made up of very large number of discrete particles, very large number of discrete particles known as the molecules. We consider the molecule level, consider system at a molecular level. These molecules have different velocities and energies. The values of these energies are constantly changing with time. If we apply force or we heat it, if we apply pressure, the molecular energy inside that body or the system changes. Okay, it gains and releases the energy. This approach to thermodynamics, which is concerned directly with the structure of a matter, is known as statical thermodynamics. Therefore, macroscopic approach is a classical thermodynamics and microscopic approach is a statical thermodynamics. Now, macroscopic approach. The analysis of microscopic system requires simple mathematical formula. Suppose we want to calculate any property or something mathematical relation, then mathematical relation of the system will be very simple if we consider microscopic approach. The behavior of the system is found by using statical method as the number of molecules is very large. So advanced statical and mathematical methods are needed to explain the changes in the system. To calculate properties of a system, we require a very complicated formula because we have to consider it at a molecular level. Microscopic approach. The value of properties of the system are their average value. The values of properties of a system are their average value, not actual value, because we are considering at a superficially. Okay, we are considering at a gross level or the total level. Therefore, we consider the average value. We cannot take it as actual value. If you want to take it actual value, then we have to consider statical thermodynamics. It means microscopic approach. For example, consider a sample of gas in a closed container. The pressure of the gas is the average value of the pressure exerted by the million of individual molecules. If the gas is stored in a vessel, then pressure exerted by each molecule is different, and the pressure exerted by each molecule is called as a partial pressure. But we do not consider that partial pressure. We consider the total or the average pressure exerted by that complete gas. Similarly, the temperature of this gas is an average value of translational kinetic energy of a million of a individual molecule. Similarly, the temperature of a gas is considered as an average temperature which is exerted by the energy, kinetic energy of a million individual molecules. Every molecule may have different temperature. Okay. But we do not consider the temperature at a molecular level. We consider average temperature of complete gas. This property, like pressure and temperature, can be measured very easily. The changes in the properties can be felt by our sense. We can sense the changes in the property. If the temperature changes, we can sense the change in temperature. But we cannot sense the change in temperature at a molecular level. We can sense at a overall level, at average level. The properties like velocity, momentum, impulse, kinetic energy, force of impact, etc., which describe the molecule, cannot be easily measured by instrument. These properties like velocity, momentum, impulse, kinetic energy, force of the impact, this cannot be calculated easily by our senses. Then microscopic. In order to describe the system, only few properties are needed. To describe macroscopic system, point of view, we required very less properties. To describe system using microscopic approach, we require a large number of properties. The large number of variables are needed to describe system, so the approach is complicated. Microscopic and macroscopic is very different, but output of the microscopic and macroscopic approach is near about same. Although the microscopic approach seems to be different from microscopic one, this exists a relation between them. Hence, when both the method are applied to the molecular system, to the particular system, then they give the same result. Now, energy and its form. Now, what is energy? We have studied it from our school. What is energy? Energy is usually defined as the ability to do mechanical work. Energy is the ability to do work. Okay. Energy is usually defined as the ability to do mechanical work. It is indeed quite difficult to precisely define the energy. We feel energy at every moment. We feel energy at every moment and can sense it very oftenly. Another broader definition of energy says that energy refers to the capacity of producing effects. In simple word, energy is ability to do work or ability to produce effects. Suppose I am pushing a block. I am effecting on it. To push a block or to push a body, I require energy. But I am not pushing that block. I am applying force, but I am not able to push that block. Then I will not call it as I have applied energy. It should be pushed. Okay. Means the work should be done. Total energy at any moment may be the algebraic sum of all the different form of energy. Now we will define different form of energy: internal energy and external energy. Okay. Now total energy is the sum of internal energy and external energy. एनर्जी कैन बी क्लासिफाइड इन द फॉलोइंग जनरल कैटेगरीज. फर्स्ट इज एनर्जी इन अ ट्रांजिशन. इट रिफर्स टू द एनर्जी दैट इज इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ ट्रांजिशन बिटवीन सब्सटेंस और द रीजन बिकॉज ऑफ सम ड्राइविंग पोटेंशियल सच एज डिफरेंस ऑफ ग्रेडियंट ऑफ फोर्स और ऑफ द टेम्परेचर और ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल पोटेंशियल एटसेट्रा. फॉर एग्जाम्पल हीट एंड वर्क. हीट एंड वर्क इज अ ट्रांजिशन एनर्जी. ओनली हीट एंड वर्क आर द ट्रांजिशन एनर्जी बिकॉज दिस हीट एंड वर्क क्रॉसेज द बाउंड्री, क्रॉसेज द सिस्टम बाउंड्री. वेन वी सप्लाई वर्क टू द सिस्टम, when we supply work to the system, it means from surrounding we are giving work to the system, means work is entering in the system, therefore it is called as transition. Suppose we are heating, we are heating the gas, and gas is considered as a system, then heat is transferred from the heat source to the system, therefore it is called as transition energy. Energy stored in a particular mass. It refers the potential and kinetic energy associated with the masses that are elevated or moving with respect to the earth. Even though a body is at rest or body is at moving, we cannot sense it, but we know it possesses some energy. Even the body is at rest, okay, the energy possessed by the body by the virtue of its position is called as a potential energy. It has some potential energy. Suppose a block is placed where a block is in a stationary condition, it possesses some energy, and that energy is a potential energy. If the block is moving with a particular velocity, that has energy, and the energy possessed by that body by the virtue of its motion is called as a kinetic energy. Apart from above broad classification, the energy can be categorized into various forms, like macroscopic energy. It refers to the energy possessed by the system considered at a macroscopic level, such as kinetic energy and potential energy. And this energy is also called as external energy. This energy produces the effect. This energy produces the effect. Okay. And the energy which produces the effect is called as external energy. Some of the popular form of energy are described below. Potential energy. The type of energy is based on the relative position of the bodies in a system, that is elevation in the gravitational field. Potential energy of the mass m at a elevation z is given as p is equal to mg z. P is potential energy, m is the mass of body, g is acceleration due to gravity, and z is the datum level, means height of that body from the ground level. Here, z is the gravitational acceleration, and the elevation is measured from some reference point. Kinetic energy, it is based on the relative moment of the bodies. Relative moment of the bodies for a mass a moving with a certain velocity c. It could be mathematically expressed as kinetic energy equal to half mv square, mc square. Here we are writing c for velocity, therefore half mc square. Microscopic energy. Microscopic energy is the energy which is at a molecular level. Molecular energy, we can say internal energy, atomic energy, molecular energy. Microscopic energy, it refers to the energy defined at molecular level. Summation of energy at molecular level all or a microscopic energy result in internal energy. Therefore, microscopic energy is called as the internal energy. Now, what is internal energy? Internal energy of the system is the energy associated with the molecular structure at molecular level. The energy possessed by the system by the virtue of its molecular motion is called as a molecular energy. another definition, internal energy may be thus comprising of sensible energy, latent energy, chemical energy and nuclear energy. Sensible energy, it refers to the kinetic energy associated with the molecules. Sensible energy is the energy possessed by the molecules by the virtue of its motion. Latent energy refers to the energy associated with phase of a substance. The energy associated with a molecule at a particular phase, if it is a liquid phase, solid phase or gas phase. Okay. The energy possessed by at its phase is called as a latent energy. Chemical energy, it refers to the energy associated with the molecular bonds. Chemical energy refers to the energy associated with the molecular bond. Molecules are attached or the bonded with another molecules. And the energy possessed by the molecular bond is called as chemical energy. Nuclear energy refers to the energy associated with the bond within the nucleus of the atom itself. The energy at the nucleus of an atom itself possesses by the virtue of its molecular bond. Total energy. Total energy of the system may be given as a summation of an effect of form of the energy at a moment. Therefore, mathematically it is written as total energy equal to kinetic energy plus potential energy plus internal energy. Kinetic energy plus potential energy, it is an external energy and IE is an internal energy. And internal energy we have seen already, sensible energy, latent energy, molecular energy, chemical energy, nuclear energy, where the K is the kinetic energy, P is potential energy, I is internal energy. Energy and its relation. Kinetic energy is represented by half mv square, where m is the mass of body and v is the velocity. Unit is also given, kilojoule. When we consider mass in kg and velocity in meter per second, listen, joule is Newton meter. Specific kinetic energy means kinetic energy possessed by the body per unit mass, that is V square by 2 or half V square. Therefore, the unit is kg per kg, kilojoule per kg, not kg per kg, kilojoule per kg. Potential energy, mgz. M is the mass of body, g is the acceleration due to gravity, z is the height from the reference point or the datum point or the from the ground level. Unit is kilojoule. But if we consider specific potential energy, then we have to consider mass as m, or the potential energy per unit mass, that is g into z. Unit is kilojoule per kg. E is the internal energy. E is the total energy, not internal energy. E is equal to U. U is the internal energy plus kinetic energy plus potential energy. U is the internal energy. U represents the internal energy and E represents the total energy. U plus half mv square plus mgz in kilojoule. Total energy at a specific level per unit mass is represented by small e. Small u represents the internal energy or the specific internal energy per unit mass. U plus small ke plus small p equal to U plus half v square plus gz. Mass flow rate is taken in kg per second. Whenever we call it as rate is related to the time. We are comparing mass with respect to time. Therefore, mass flow rate is represented by m dot and rho into volume, density into volume, or rho AV, density area into velocity, average velocity, rho AV. then energy flow rate E dot is equal to m into E, and here m dot, E dot is equal to m dot into E. M dot is mass flow rate in kg per second. Since it is kg per second, joule per second is what, and mass flow rate is in kg per second, so it is a kilojoule per second. Heat. The heat may be termed as a energy interaction at a system boundary which occurs due to temperature difference only. Now, how we can say that a body is got heated? Body is got heated. We can sense it by sensing the change in temperature. Suppose we are heating the body. Initially, temperature of body is less. We can sense it. As we are heating the body, temperature of body increases. We can sense the change in temperature. Then we can call it as a body is got heated. Heat is observable in transit at the interface, that is boundary. It cannot be contained in a system. It is a transit. It cannot be contained. A hot body is placed in the atmosphere. It will not be contained in the body itself. It will transfer from body to atmosphere because atmospheric temperature is comparatively low. The hot body. In general, the heat transfer to the system is assigned with a positive, while the heat transfer from the system is assigned with a negative. Heat supplied to the system is considered as positive, and heat rejected from the system is considered as a negative. Listen, whenever we supply heat to the system is taken as positive, and when system gives the heat or system rejects the heat, it is considered as a negative. Heat transferred to the system or heat given through the system is a positive. Heat transfer from the system or heat rejected from the system is negative. Unit of heat in MKS is a calorie, in SI is joule. The thermodynamic work can be defined as the work shall be done by the system if the total effect outside the system is equivalent to rising the weight, and this work shall be positive work. Work done on the system is always negative. Whenever we supply the work to the system is negative. Work done by system is positive, work done on system is negative. Remember, it is opposite to the heat. Heat transfer to system is positive, heat transfer by the system is negative. Work transfer to system is negative, work transfer by the system is positive. Or in other words, we say work done by system is positive. System is made up for giving some work. If it is not able to give work, it is consuming the work. If it is consuming work, it is negative. If the system is able to give work, then it is positive. Consider a turbine in a thermal power plant or hydroelectric power plant. Turbine gives the electricity. It is giving some output. Therefore, work done by the turbine is positive. Suppose we are running some motor. To run motor requires electricity. We are supplying electricity to the motor. We are giving work to the motor. It means this work is a negative work. If the work is absorbed by the system, then it is negative work. If the work is given by system, it is positive work. In the above definition, the work has been defined as a positive work and says that there need not be actual rising of weight, but the effect of this system behavior must be reducible to the rising of the weight and nothing else. Its unit are Newton meter or joule. Newton meter is nothing but a joule. Newton meter is nothing but a joule. In MKS, it is calorie. Heat and work are transit form of energy and both are mutually convertible. Heat and work is a transit energy and both are mutually convertible. means heat can be converted into work and work can be converted into heat. Now you can say the system. Consider this example. When the weight is fall down or weight is displaced, the piston reciprocates inside the cylinder and the friction between piston and cylinder produces the heat. Means work done by the weight is converted into heat energy. Now density, specific gravity and specific volume. We have already studied in 12th class density. Density is defined as the ratio of mass and volume. It is the ratio of mass and volume is the density. Density is denoted by rho, rho symbol. Mass upon volume. The unit of mass is kg and volume is meter cube. Therefore, unit is kg per meter cube in SI system. Sometimes the density of a substance is given relative to the density of the well-known substance, then it is called as specific gravity. Suppose density of any substance is given in a relation with some standard substance, then the density of that substance is called as a specific gravity or relative density, and is defined as the ratio of density of substance to the density of some standard substance at a specified temperature. Usually water at 4 degrees Celsius, for which rho H2O is 1000 kg per meter cube, and water is considered as standard fluid to measure density or the specific gravity or relative density. Suppose density of petrol is 800 kg per meter cube. I want to calculate specific gravity or relative density, then I have to divide density of petrol by the density of water. 800 upon 1000, it will be 0.8. therefore specific gravity of petrol is 0.8. specific gravity is denoted by density of a particular substance upon density of water. The reciprocal of density is the specific volume. Reciprocal of density, listen here, density is mass upon volume, then reciprocal is volume upon mass. Therefore volume per unit mass is a specific volume, which is defined as a volume per unit mass. Therefore specific volume is represented by small v, and it is the ratio of total volume upon mass, or we can say 1 upon rho. Specific volume is 1 by rho, 1 by density, reciprocal of density. Temperature is a thermal state of a body which distinguishes a hot body from the cold body. It is a degree of hotness or coldness. How we can sense the temperature? We can sense the temperature by touching a body, whether a body is cold or hot. When we touch the body, we can sense, or we can tell the temperature also if we touch the body. Okay, by sensing the temperature, and that sense will be observed with the help of hotness and coldness of body. If the body is cold, we can say that the temperature is less than the normal temperature, below the atmospheric temperature. If the body is hot, we can say the temperature is greater than atmospheric temperature. The temperature of the body is proportional to the stored molecular energy. The temperature of body is proportional to stored energy. The energy possessed by the body is the energy possessed by the temperature of the body itself. That is the average molecular kinetic energy of the molecule in the system. A particular molecule does not have the temperature. It has energy. The gas as a system has a temperature. Instruments for measuring the ordinary temperature are known as thermometer, and those who measure the very high temperature is known as pyrometer. To measure normal temperature, अप टू 100-150 डिग्री सेल्सियस वी यूज नॉर्मली थर्मोमीटर, बट टू मेजर वेरी हाई टेम्परेचर वी हैव टू यूज पायरोमीटर और थर्मल लेजर थर्मोमीटर. जीरोथ लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनामिक्स. वाई जीरोथ लॉ, वाई नॉट फर्स्ट लॉ? यू माइट हैव हर्ड अबाउट दी न्यूटन्स फर्स्ट लॉ, सेकेंड लॉ, थर्ड लॉ. वाई नॉट न्यूटन्स जीरोथ लॉ? एक्चुअली फर्स्ट लॉ वॉज इन्वेंट, सॉरी, जीरोथ लॉ वॉज इन्वेंटेड आफ्टर फर्स्ट लॉ. फर्स्ट लॉ वॉज इन्वेंटेड एंड द रिसर्चर्स थॉट दैट द जीरोथ लॉ शुड कम बिफोर द फर्स्ट लॉ. और वॉट इज जीरोथ लॉ? जीरोथ लॉ रिप्रेजेंट्स द इक्विलिब्रियम कंडीशन वेन द बॉडी ए इज इन थर्मल इक्विलिब्रियम विथ बॉडी बी एंड बॉडी बी इज इन थर्मल इक्विलिब्रियम विथ द बॉडी सी, देन बॉडी ए एंड बॉडी सी आर इन थर्मल इक्विलिब्रियम. आफ्टर इन्वेंटिंग द फर्स्ट लॉ, इन्वेंटर कम टू नो दैट दिस लॉ शुड कम बिफोर द फर्स्ट लॉ, देयरफॉर दैट लॉ इज गिवन एज जीरोथ लॉ. एंड दिस लॉ इज अ बेसिस फॉर इन्वेंटिंग द थर्मोमीटर. Now I will tell you how thermometer is invented. Consider a water. Water is kept in a fridge and its temperature is reduced to ice point. Now check the temperature of ice and give that temperature as a 0 degree Celsius. Now boil the water and check the temperature of boiling water and consider is at 100 degree Celsius. Now divide 0 and 100 into 100 parts. When you measure the temperature of ice, take it as a 0 degree Celsius. Measure the temperature of boiling water, take it as 100 degree Celsius, and divide 0 and 100 into 100 parts. Each part represents the 1 degree Celsius. Each part represents the 1 degree Celsius. Zeroth law of thermodynamics states that if the body A and body B are in thermal equilibrium with body C separately, then two bodies A and B are also in thermal equilibrium. When body A and body B are in thermal equilibrium with C separately, then body A and body B also in thermal equilibrium. Or in other words, we can say when body A is in thermal equilibrium with body B and body B is in thermal equilibrium with body C, then A and C are in thermal equilibrium. You can write in a V, in V, in any form. This is the principle of temperature measurement. This is the principle of temperature measurement. As I given you example of ice and boiling water, block diagram shows the zeroth law of thermodynamics and its application of the temperature measurement respectively. Listen here, body A is in thermal equilibrium with body B and body B is in thermal equilibrium with body C, then body C and body A are also in thermal equilibrium. See the another example. This body is in thermal equilibrium with, this is the reference body at a state, the body whose temperature is to be measured, and this is a thermometer. We consider it as a ice, the measure the temperature, it gives some temperature particular, measure the temperature of, suppose this is the boiling water, measure the temperature. Now the thermometer will give different reading and divide that reading into 100 parts. It has been found that a gas will not occupy any volume at a certain temperature. This temperature is known as absolute zero temperature. At absolute zero temperature, a gas will not occupy any volume. And what is absolute zero temperature? Minus 273 degrees Celsius or zero Kelvin is absolute zero temperature. The temperature measured with absolute zero are the basis are called as absolute temperature. Absolute temperature is stated in degrees centigrade or Kelvin. The point of absolute temperature is found to occur at 273.15 degree Celsius below the freezing point of water. Below the freezing point of water means freezing point is 0 degree Celsius and below freezing point 273.15 degrees. Below freezing point means it is a negative minus 273 degree Celsius, and minus 273 degree Celsius is 0 Kelvin. I will explain what is Kelvin. The absolute temperature thermometer reading is a degree Celsius plus 273.15. Absolute temperature is measured in Kelvin, and the Kelvin is thermometer temperature in degree Celsius plus 273.15. Absolute temperature is in degree Celsius is known as a degrees Kelvin, denoted by K in SI unit. Okay. Temperature scale we'll see next class.